Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting today, we have a few updates to do with the recent launch of the ANASIS-II mission. Then, as per usual, we have some small Boca Chica and Starship updates, as well as SN5 testing and the next Starship prototype. Let's head straight in and get up to date. As I just mentioned, starting off the video today, we have the recently launched ANASIS-II satellite. Falcon 9 successfully lifted off, carrying South Korea's first military communications satellite. The booster used for this mission was B-1058.2 and had previously flown carrying Bob and Doug. As expected, this booster then came down and performed a successful second landing on the Just Read the Instructions drone ship. During the live stream, SpaceX mentioned that for this mission they had sent out Gomez Tree and Gomez Chief. After a while of floating and guiding themselves down towards the ocean, Elon Musk confirmed that SpaceX had caught both fairings. Here we have a video of one of the fairing halves being caught. Then here we have a video of the other fairing half being caught. Finally, for the SpaceX updates in the ANASIS-II mission, this was a record-breaking launch. Apparently, the previously held turnaround time for an orbital rocket was 54 days held by Space Shuttle Atlantis. However, this mission from SpaceX and booster B-1058 marks a 51-day turnaround time. So SpaceX, on top of their long list of existing accolades, have obtained yet another record. Musk responded to this tweet to say, "Still long way to go, reuse only matters to degree that it's rapid and complete." With the ANASIS-II launch covered, there isn't any more standard updates to talk about, so let's head to Boca Chica. We'll be starting these updates with the high bay. As you can see, SpaceX have progressed further and are starting to work on the second level. So far, they've already constructed one corner of the second level of this huge building. I'm not sure how many of these levels they'll need, but they've been working tirelessly on this so far. In terms of infrastructure updates, there really isn't anything else to show. Most of the other construction around the facility is still ongoing, but not worth showing. However, you can see here that we have an interesting and unexpected Starship update. This is SN2 and is a retired Bopper test tank and was built simply for pressure testing like SN7. For a while, it has been sitting on a concrete stand in the production area, but recently, engineers have been working on it. Also, something else to show before we look at SN5 is some new arrivals. Here, we have some robots that will be used for welding. We thought SpaceX was already going fast, well now they can move even faster and probably have cleaner welds. Next up on the list is SN5, which you all know has been preparing for a static fire and hop recently. After the SN4 boom, due to ground support equipment, they had to rebuild the launch mount. Whilst it took quite a while to get everything ready for the next round of testing, it looks like we've now reached that point. Monday, July 20th, throughout a portion of the day, SpaceX began filling up the SN5 tank. They performed a successful ambient pressure test, as you can see no ice formed on the outside of the tank. Not too much to look at, but you can see bits of venting here and there. What's cool about this testing is that as it was happening, SpaceX were getting ready to launch another rocket. ANASIS-II lifted off while SpaceX were testing this SN5 prototype. It was really cool to watch the NSF stream, where at some point they had a Starship tank livestream and a Falcon 9 livestream side by side. Teslarati tweeted an article about how SpaceX is working on its next upgraded full-scale Starship prototype. Musk responded to say, "We are rapidly changing alloy constituents and forming methods, so traditional names like 304L will become more of an approximation." After this tweet, Musk was asked about an update on SN5, to which Musk responded with, "We'll attempt to fly later this week." So, looking at the dates, you can see that the primary date of the static fire is today, July 22nd. Then, SpaceX also have static fire backup dates of July 23rd and July 24th. So we will have a static fire occur in the next few days, then by the end of the week we should see a hop. Finally, like with the last video, we have even more progression with future Starship vehicles. For a while, we've been uncertain what serial number the next Starship tank might be. There was a bit of uncertainty because Musk mentioned a second SN7 test tank. However, here you can see the common bulkhead that will be used for the SN8 prototype. But how exactly do we know that this next Starship will be SN8? It's because, in usual SpaceX fashion, as you can see, they've added a label to the dome. Anyway, this bulkhead has since been moved onto a construction mount, as you can see here. I wasn't expecting it this soon, but also turns out that this common bulkhead has since been sleeved. So right here, we have the first piece of SN8. Also having some attention recently is the fins we previously saw attached to Mark 1. They've been spotted on the move again after a very nice clean recently. We have a few more future Starship bits and pieces to look at. Here, we have the recently stacked fairing section. The nose cone is still currently being welded to the rings as it's not quite complete yet. As you can see by Jack Bayer's great editing, the incomplete welds are visible on the left and the complete welds on the right. Looks like here an engineer is inspecting the welds. So along with that newly built fairing section, we also recently saw another two nose cones outside. However, if you thought SpaceX didn't already have enough noses, yet another one has been spotted. You can see here a brand new nose cone under construction in the fabrication tent. Then, also spotted in a fabrication tent was a brand new ring stack. Not sure what it will be for, however I doubt it will be very long at all before it pops out of the tent and moves to where it's needed. So while SpaceX seem to be continuing to progress with infrastructure, they are also speeding up production. As always, I like to reserve this part of the video to say a massive thank you to Mary Boca Chica Girl. She spends hours out in the hot Texas sun and whilst filming SN5 also even got stung by a bee. However, I also want to thank the rest of the NSF team as they do an incredible job with their live streams. As I said previously in the video, on Monday they had a dual live stream with footage from both Texas and Florida. Thank you all so much. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.